Hey students, in our last lecture of business research methods, we had left the lecture with a question that if we assume, if our null hypothesis is that the average height of buildings is equal to 3 meter, and when we calculate using certain samples and we find and we measure that the average height of buildings is 3.1 meter, then should we say that, should we expect or should we think that, okay, this is close to 3, so we should say that our null hypothesis is accepted, or should we say that this 3.1 is significantly different or far away from 3, so the null hypothesis cannot be accepted? So this was the question. I would add one more question to this scenario. If we calculate the average height of buildings and if this height is 2.5 meter, if it is 2.5 meter, then what can we say? So I hope that most of the students would say that, okay, 2.5 is significantly different, significantly away from 3. So when the measured value of buildings average height or mean of height is 2.3, then we can say that this null hypothesis is not accepted. But when it is 3.1, then the students must have some doubts. So let's clear these doubts. So when the values are quite close to our assumed values, then we must think something beyond it. So if it is just another assumption, if this measured value would be exactly 3, we had assumed 3, and when we take sample and then measure, then it would have been 3, then what would have you said? Then you or a researcher would have said that I am 100% sure that the average height of buildings is equal to 3 meter because we had assumed this, and now on the basis of sample again we have found this. So it is almost 100%, or you may say 99%, because our calculation has, sample calculation has also shown the same figures. So 99% we are sure that this is clear. But when it is 3.1, 2.9 or something close to 3, then the researcher may say or may try to find out whether the researcher is 99% sure, whether the researcher is 95% sure, 90% sure, and so on. So depending on this, the researcher actually calculates the value that is significant or not. So the researcher needs to calculate, after calculating these measured value, the researcher also needs to do something else. The researcher needs to calculate whether this value obtained through sampling, that is 3.1, is significantly different or not. Means, is it significant or not? So here the use of test of significance is there. So I'll just explain the definition first, then we'll discuss in easier words. A significance level is a critical probability associated with a statistical hypothesis test. So the test that we had been conducting is a statistical hypothesis test. So it is a probability associated with that, that how much probability is that indicates how likely it is that an inference supporting a difference between an observed value and some statistical expectation is true. So actually what we are trying to be sure, what we are trying to find out the probability about, that the probability of that whether the expected value and calculated value have the same relationship or the same difference that has been assumed. Means if we had assumed that there is difference in those values, is it significantly true or is it significantly different? So is this different significant or not? So actually we are, what we are trying to find out, that there is 3 assumed value, there is 3.1 calculated value. Is this difference significant or not? So this is how or what we are trying to find out on the basis of test of significance. Again, I am telling that we have calculated one value, that is we had assumed one value, that is 3, and we have calculated a value, that is 3.1. So now on the basis of test of significance, we are trying to find out whether this difference is significant or not. We are using test of significance to understand, to find out whether this difference is significant or not. So in other words, whether this difference is big enough or not. Significant, I am using a different word for significant, is big enough. So the value assumed is 3, value calculated is 3.1, and we are trying to find out whether this difference is significant or not, whether this difference is big enough or not, and how much we are sure that this difference is significant or not. So whether we are 95% or 99% sure that this difference is significant, or we are sure that this difference is not significant. Whatever we are trying, whatever we are saying, if we say that this difference is significant, are we 95 or 99% sure? Or whether we say that this difference is not significant, are we 95 or 99 or 90% sure? So how much sure we are that whether this difference is significant? So it is very simple to understand. As soon as we increase the probability of our sureness or being affirmed that this results are significant, then the gap would definitely be smaller. Means if I am just trying to be 50% sure that the difference is significant, then a larger difference would not be considered. But if I am trying to be around 95 or 99% sure that the difference is not significant, then those values should have very close values. Means, like, once again, if it is 3 and 3.1, these values are close, and if we want to be 99% sure that the calculated value and assumed values are not having much difference, then these values should not be very different, should be even closer. And if we are just trying to be 50% or 80% sure that these values are not significantly different, then this small difference is not very much. So what is done for this test of significance? When a researcher starts research, researcher assumes that the researcher want, how much the researcher wants to be sure about this. So what is the probability p value for this? So what is the probability of being sure that the difference is significant or difference is not significant? Whatever results we are actually getting, how much sure we are about that results. So the term p-value stands for probability value and is another name for an observed or computed significance level. So I'll take this example further. So we had calculated the value as 3.1 maybe, and our assumed value was 3. So how would we find out that whether this difference is significant or not? How would we find out whether this difference is significant or not? What would we do? We would use these two formulas for calculation. Critical value, that is 3 minus lower limit, and this gives us one value, and critical value minus upper limit, this gives us another value. and while calculating these values we would find the upper and lower limits or values beyond which it would be assumed that the difference is significant, and less than that it would be assumed that the difference is not significant. I'll take example further. For example, we had taken this. So our mu is 3, then z is the value of p that we had taken. So if we are taking it for 95%, then z value is 1.96. If we are taking it 99%, z value will be around 2.58%. If we are taking it 90%, z value will be different. So depending on how much sure we want to be, we take 95, 99, 90 or so on. So depending on this, we take z value. Then s is standard deviation. We take standard deviation of the sample. We can calculate the standard deviation of sample upon under root n. Under root n is the sample size. So mu is 3, z if we take 95%, 1.96, s standard deviation calculated, and n the sample size, maybe 300, 200, 250, 500, whatever it is. So on the basis of this, we calculate lower limit and we also calculate upper limit, and these values will be close to 3. So in our this example, we had taken some assumed values of s and n, and we have taken z as 1.96 for 95%. So this is what our calculation result was. So the result of the calculation, upper value was 3.196 and the lower value was 2.804 for 95%. So this curve in the center, it is the hypothesized value, that was 3, and then on right hand side upper limit for this value, and for left hand side lower limit for this value. So 3.196 is the upper limit, 2.804 is the lower limit. So after this calculation we can find out that any value upper side 3 to 3.196 is considered as not significant difference. It means it would be assumed that it is, our null hypothesis can be accepted. And at lower side, if there will be any value between 2.804 to 3, it would be assumed not significantly different from 3. This is the right word that we need to say, not significantly different from our assumed value 3. So 2.804 to 3 is whatever value we get in between, this is assumed that this is not significantly different from 3 at 95% confidence level, 95% sure that this is not significantly different from 3. And so any value between 2.804 and 3.196 would be assumed as almost equal to 3, means would be assumed as null hypothesis accepted, and any values beyond these would be expected, would be assumed as significantly different, and so the null hypothesis rejected. Any values between 2.804 and 3.196 are taken as not significantly different from assumed value, and that is why null hypothesis accepted, and beyond these assumed or taken as significantly different from our assumed value 3, and that is why null hypothesis not accepted, or you may say rejected. So this is all for this. We'll discuss more about different types of type 1 error and type 2 error in next lectures. Thank you.